you believe. Give charity for the pleasure of Allah. The pleasure of Allah. Oh, you who believe, read the Quran every night of Ramadan. Night of Ramadan. Welcome, oh Ramadan. It is Ramadan. It is Ramadan.
Dear brothers and sisters in Islam and humanity, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, the mercy, and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. Welcome to the show Ramadan, a date with Dr. Zakia. I'm your host, Yusuf Chambers, and today we will be discussing the topic Eid al-Fitr. Dr. Zakia, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Well, Dr. Zakia, yesterday, of course, we discussed the topic Zakat al-Fitr, and we had a very interesting discussion about that subject and some questions from our viewers. And today, we need to move on to Eid al-Fitr, which is a wonderful celebration for the Muslims. But I would very much like you now to define the term Eid.
Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah. وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. The word Eid means something which is habitual. It also means to return. It also means to repeat. In short, Eid means it is a recurring event. And it can also be used for a particular place which people visit periodically. It can also mean a time period where a particular act is done regularly. The plural of Eid is Ayad. It is a day of gathering. The Eid, it derived from the Arabic word Ada, which means to return. And people return this event every year. That's Eid. And Ibn al-Arabi, he says that the reason Eid is called because it returns the happiness every year. And the word Eid, some people say, is also derived from Adah, which means the custom, which means tradition. So people accustomed to celebrating Eid, therefore the word Eid is there. According to Musnad Ahmad, volume number 3, hadith number 12006, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day enters the city of Medina, and before, in the days of Jahiliyyah, in the days of ignorance, the people of Medina used to celebrate 2 days of sports and amusement. One was the day of Nehruz, which was the new year. The other was the day of Maharajan, which was the final day of the year. So Prophet ﷺ says that you people in the days of Jahiliyyah used to celebrate 2 days with sports and amusement. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced it with 2 better days. The days of Nahar, that is the day of sacrifice, and the day of Fitr, that is the day of breaking, indicating the Eidain, the 2 Eid we have, Eid al-Adha and the Eid al-Fitr. They are replaced with the previous days of Jahiliyyah. So here we come to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has replaced the days of Jahiliyyah, where people used to enjoy with play and amusement, with days that are better, the day of sacrifice, the day of forgiveness, etc., which is much better for them for this world as well as for the Akhirah.
Okay, Jazakallah khair. Well, Dr. Zakia, in the morning of the Eid, it's a requirement for the Muslim to go out and do the Eid prayer. Could you explain, for the benefit of myself and the viewers, what are the rulings regarding the Eid prayer?
As far as the prayer for Eid is concerned, our beloved Prophet Muhammad said, it's mentioned in Sahih Muslim, volume number 2, in the Book of Fasting, hadith number 2534. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, said that the Prophet Muhammad, he said that fasting is prohibited on 2 days, on Eid al Fitr and Eid al-Adha. That means on the 2 days of Eidain, Eid al-Fitr, that's breaking of the fast, any day of Adha, that is the Eid day of sacrifice. These 2 days is prohibited. So no one can fast on these 2 days. As far as the ruling is concerned about the Salah for Eid al-Fitr, there are differences of opinion amongst the scholars and the different schools of thought. According to Imam Shafi and Imam Malik, the Shafi's and the Malikis, they say that the Eid Salah is a sunnah-e-muqaddah. It is a very important sunnah known as mustahab. Based on the hadith that the Bedouin who comes and says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not made us compulsory any salah other than the 5 prescribed salah, which is mentioned in Mughni, volume number 2, page number 223. So based on this hadith that no other salah is compulsory besides the 5 times prescribed salah, they say that this salah of Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, it is sunnat al-muqaddah. According to the Hanbali school of thought, the Hanbalis, they say it is farz-e-kifaya. That means it's a farz, as long as some people from the community do it, it's enough. It's not farz on every individual, farz-e-kifaya. And the third ruling, that is according to Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah have mercy on him, he said that it is farz, it is wajib. And this view is also of Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, that praying Eid al-Fitr Salah and Eid al-Adha Salah, it is fard. And the ruling is based on the verse of the Quran of Surah Qawthar, chapter number 108, verse number 2, which says, Inna atainaka al-Qawthar, fasalli lirabbika wanhar. Fasalli lirabbika wanhar means, and turn to the Lord in prayer and sacrifice. So it indicates that you have to offer the Eid Salah of Eid al-Adha and then sacrifice. So based on this world, they say it is compulsory to offer the Eid Salah. And there are various other Sahih Hadith in which Prophet Muhammad has commanded the Muslims that they should offer Salah. Not only to the general Muslims, even to the women who are menstruating, he said, go for Eid Salah, even if you don't have to offer Salah. He said, the veil woman, even the virgin, whether they're young or matured, they should go for Eid Salah. And the menstruating women, even if they can't offer, they should at least go to the Musalla. It's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, hadith number 351, as well as hadith number 324. And various other hadiths. The Prophet even said that the children should go. And based on this hadith, the Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah have mercy on him, and Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy on him too, they said that offering is Salah is fard. There is one more hadith in Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, hadith number 1068, where the beloved Prophet Muhammad said that we have 2 Eids together, that is Eid al-Fitr and the Jummah Salah. Even Jummah is supposed to be a weekly Eid. So he says that after offering the Eid al-Fitr Salah, he says that those who do not want to offer Jummah Salah may not do it if they don't want to. But we will offer Jummah Salah, indicating that because you offered Eid al-Fitr, Jummah Salah, which is more important than the 5 prescribed Salah. Here, the Prophet said, if you offer Eid al-Fitr in congregation, Jummah Salah may not be offered that day. But naturally, they have to offer the normal Duhar Salah. So this surely indicates that Eid al-Fitr is a Farz Salah. And I agree with the view of Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah have mercy on him, as well as Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy on him too.
Ameen, inshallah. And of course, it's such a wonderful opportunity for the Muslims to gather and, you know, feel good about themselves. And we need lots of opportunities to feel good about ourselves right now, inshallah. Dr. Zakir, could you explain when the Eid prayer is first allowed to be prayed early in the morning, and when's the last time it can be prayed?
As far as the timing of the Eid Salah is concerned, it can be prayed any time after the sun rises approximately 3 meters above the horizon till it reaches the meridian. And majority of the scholars, they say that once the sun rises about the height of a spear above the horizon, that's to the naked eye but natural, And till the time it reaches the zenith, you can offer the prayer in between this. So before it reaches the zenith is the last time, and earliest time is after it rises from the horizon one spear above the height of the horizon. The hadith in Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, hadith number 1131, Abdullah ibn Basr, he was one of the companions of the Prophet. He one day goes to offer Salah during the day of breaking of the fast or the day of sacrifice, offer the Eid Salah. And he disliked that the Imam, he delayed in offering the Eid Salah. And he said, at the time of the Prophet, at our times, by this time, the prayer used to end. That's in the forenoon. So praying early is preferable in the forenoon. And according to Ibn Qudama, who writes in his book Al-Mughni, in volume number 2, page number 224, he says that as far as Eid al-Adha is concerned, the Eid of the sacrifice, it should be prayed as early as possible. After the sun rises, after one spear of height from the horizon, it should be prayed as early as possible because people have to go back home, they have to sacrifice, then later on they have to cook the food so that, you know, they can have the meal of the sacrifice by afternoon. And as far as the Salah for Eid al-Fitr is concerned, it should be delayed so that people can give Zakat al-Fitr to those who are supposed to receive it, as the Prophet said, that give Zakat al-Fitr before the Eid Salah. So it's preferable to delay the Eid al-Fitr Salah. So this is a ruling as far as the timing of Eid Salah is concerned.
JazakAllah khair for the answer, Dr. Zakir.
Dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, we'll meet soon after a short break.
It is Ramadan.
My name is Shakiri.
My name is Nasim Abdul Rahman.
My name is Faraj Wahaj.
My name is Musa Bena.
I was a Christian.
Hindu.
I had a Christian upbringing.
When I asked 10 people about Hinduism, I used to get 10 different answers.
My heart was attracted to Islam.
Oh yeah, I used to ask a lot of questions to the priests and I wasn't getting the answers.
Why did I become a Muslim? Allah knows best.
Alhamdulillah, I've made the right choice.
My choice, from ignorance to Islam.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala un logon par raham nahi karta jo logon par raham nahi karte. Jo insaan logon ko neki ki taraf bulayega usko bhi wahi ajr milega jo us neki karne wale ko milega. Ilm ka hasil karna har musalman par farz hai. Tarikhiyon se ujalon ki taraf lane wali baat Rasool sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki baat.
Rasool ki baat.
Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. But this, it's a win-win choice. Peaceful, win the battle for peace. Do contribute a dollar for a media cause, just for a media purpose, divine.
Support Peace TV. Send your donation and zakat to Islamic Research Foundation International, Islamic Bank of Britain, Coventry Road, Birmingham, UK. Account number 011-32301. Sort code 300083.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Living the faith in the spirit of Islam. Sheikh Faizur Rahman ke saath Allah ke kalam ka bayan.
Allah ne jin cheezon ke karne ka hukm diya hai un cheezon ko kare aur Allah ne jin cheezon se bachne ka hukm diya hai un cheezon se bache aur apne aap ko bachaye. Hu Allahu Ahad. Wo Allah ek hai. Allah tbarak wa taala shirk ko maaf nahi karega. Main tumhare Allah Allah kehne ki wajah se paak nahi ho gaya. Main to pehle hi se paak hu.
بلکہ تمہاری گندی زبان میرا پاک نام لینے کی وجہ سے پاک ہو گئی۔
اے ایمان والو، جب نماز کے لیے جمعہ کے دن تم کو پکارا جائے تو فاسعوا الی ذکر اللہ، اللہ کے ذکر کی طرف دوڑ پڑو۔
ذکر قرآن۔
فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ
آیات ربانی قرات۔
Dear brothers and sisters in Islam and humanity, Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to the show Ramadan, a date with Dr. Zakia. I'm your host Yusuf Chambers, and today we're discussing the topic Eid al-Fitr. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Dr. Zakia, could you explain to me what is the authentic method for performing the Eid prayer? And perhaps you would give us a short description for the benefit of the viewers watching today.
As far as Eid Salah is concerned, there are different types of Muslims pray, and there are different opinions. But as far as you go over the authentic sources, the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, then you have one common method. And according to the authentic sources of all the Sahih Hadith, if you collect, we come to know that as far as the Eid Salah is concerned, whether it be Eid al-Fitr or Eid al-Adha, we have to offer two Salah, two Rakat Salah, two units of Salah. It's mentioned in the Hadith of Sunan Bayhaqi, volume number 3, book of Jummah Salah, Hadith number 5719, Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, radiallahu anhu. He said that the traveler's prayer is two rakat, the Adha prayer is two rakat, talking about Eid al-Adha, and the Jummah prayer is two rakat. This is the full length of all these prayers as it came from the Messenger of Allah. That means Eid Salah should be two rakat. Point number two, that before Eid Salah, there is no Adhan and there is no Aqama. It's mentioned in Sahih Muslim, volume number 2. In the book of Salah, Hadith number 1929, Jabir ibn Samura, he said that he prayed along with the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala both the Eids on more than one or two occasions, and there was no Adhan and no Aqama. That means for each Salah, there should be no Adhan and no Aqama. It's different than the normal congregation Salah. Point number 3, that there is no Salah before the Eid Salah and after the Eid Salah. There's no two rakah sunnah before or after that. And it's mentioned in the Hadith of Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, Hadith number 1155, where Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, he says that the Prophet came out to pray the Eid Salah on Eid al-Fitr day, and he offered two rakat. And before that and after that, he did not pray. That means before and after Eid Salah, there are no other prayers. Further, point number 4, when a person starts the Eid Salah, he should say the Takbir al-Ihram, that's Allahu Akbar, and then say the open supplication. This is followed by 7 Takbir in the first rakat, and in the second rakat, he should say 5 Takbir. This we come to know from the authentic sources of Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, Hadith number 1145 and 1146, where Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha, may Allah be pleased with her, she says that the Prophet, when he used to offer the Eid al-Fitr Salah and the Eid al-Adha Salah, that means Salah of both the Eid, he used to say 7 Takbir in the first rakat and 5 Takbir in the second rakat. This is the authentic way of offering Eid Salah. After that, a person should say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم I seek refuge with Allah from Satan the accursed and in the name of Allah most gracious most merciful and then he should recite Surah Fatiha and after Surah Fatiha in the first rakat recite Surah Qaf chapter number 50 followed by in the second rakat Surah Qamar chapter number 54 or in the first rakat he can recite Surah Allah chapter number 87 and second rakat Surah Ghashiyah chapter number 88 both these types of first and second rakat have been proven from authentic hadith but even if a person recites any other surah any other verse of the Quran yet the salah will be accepted these are the recommended ones it is sunnah which the prophet recited furthermore after the Eid salah there is a khutbah of the Eid salah it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari volume number 2 in the book of two Eids hadith number 962 Ibn Abbas may Allah repeat me said that he has offered Eid salah with the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with Abu Bakr with Umar with Uthman may Allah be pleased with them all and all of them they offered the Eid salah first then was followed by the khutbah all of them they gave the khutbah after offering the Eid salah it's further mentioned in Sunan Abu Dawud volume number 1 in the book of salah hadith number 1151 prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after offering Eid salah and before starting the khutbah of Eid he said that all those who want to listen to the khutbah can listen to the khutbah all those who want to go they can go now here is a very important point most of the time you find in the khutbah of Eid salah most of the imams say they don't get up it is wrong and they prevent them from going and they say you have a sin and they say many things it's haram to get up etc imagine the prophet muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he gave the khutbah he said if you want to listen you can listen if you want to go you can go does it mean that the imam the khutbah that they give today is much more important than the khutbah of prophet muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam it's a pity the sahih hadith say that the prophet muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said if you want to hear the khutbah you can hear if you want to you can go but it's preferable to hear the khutbah but the prophet gave permission that if they want they can go and further it's mentioned in sunan abu daud volume number 1 in the book of salah hadith number 1068 the prophet said that both the eid have synchronized the Eid al-Fitr and the Friday. Friday is called as weekly Eid. So those who do not want to offer the Jummah Salah may not do it because the Eid Salah in congregation is sufficient. But we will offer the Jummah Salah. That means, imagine, the Eid prayer is so important in congregation. So if it falls on the same day, Eid Salah is sufficient. Jummah Salah may not be prayed, but if you pray it is good, alhamdulillah. But those who don't pray Jummah Salah, it becomes compulsory that they should pray the Duhar Salah. So this was in short regarding the authentic way of offering the Eid Salah.
Okay. Well, Jazakallah khair, Dr. Zaki. I'm sure that throws a lot of light on the absolute authentic method. As you say, there are many different people out there doing different things, and it'll be nice for us to do what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has recommended us to, indeed, inshallah. Dr. Zakia, could you explain the importance of women attending the Eid prayer, please?
As far as Eid Salah is concerned, it's compulsory for all the men to attend, and even the children, including the women, irrespective of whether they're young or they're old, whether they're single, whether they're married. Even if they're menstruating, the Prophet said they should attend, even though they don't have to offer Salah, they have to attend. And there are various hadith which speak about this. It's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, in the book of Salah, hadith number 351, that Umm Atiyah, may Allah be pleased with her, she said that we were ordered that all the women, even the menstruating women and the veiled women, they should go for Eid Salah, even though the menstruating women should keep away from Musalla. That means they should not offer Salah, that they should go. And when one woman, asked the Prophet, that, oh Prophet, what if a woman does not have a veil? So the Prophet replied, she should share the veil of a companion. That means she should borrow the veil from the companion. Even though she is not veiled, she should borrow. It is that important to attend the Eid congregation. And Umm Atiyah continues and says that may Allah be pleased with her, that we were asked at least to attend the gathering and the invocation. You know, those menstruating women who cannot pray, at least they should attend the invocation and the gathering. It's further mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 2, in the book of two Eids, hadith number 975. Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that when he was a young boy, he went with the Prophet for the Eid Salah, and he said he doesn't remember whether it was Eid al-Adha or Eid al-Fitr. And after the Salah, the Prophet gave the sermon, and then he addressed the women, and he preached to them, and he said that they should give alms, they should give charity. It further mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 1, in the book of Menses, hadith number 324, that Hafsa, may Allah be pleased with her, she says that we did not allow our virgin woman to go for Eid Salah. And she continues. Then a lady comes and she says that my sister was the wife of one of the companions of the Prophet. And we used to attend to the soldiers during the fights in the battlefield. And she continues. And the Prophet said that the menstruating woman and the veiled woman should go for Eid Salah. And if she does not have a veil, she should borrow the veil from the companion. Later on, Umm Atiyah, may Allah be pleased with her, she enters. So she asks her, that have you heard so-and-so thing? So she said, yes. That's what the Prophet said, that even the menstruating woman and the matured virgin woman and the young virgin woman and the married woman, they should go for each salah. And if the veiled woman does not have a veil, she should borrow the veil from a companion. So Hafsa, may Allah be pleased with her, asked, menstruating woman? She said, yes. Don't they go at the Arafah? So they can go for invocation, they can go to attend the gathering, though they don't have to offer salah. It's mentioned in Musannaf Ibn Shaybah, volume 2, hadith number 5786, that Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, he is to take complete of his family for the Eid Salah. As much as of his family that he can take, he takes for the Eid Salah. So this shows that the women, they should go for the Eid Salah. Even if they're menstruating, if they cannot offer Salah, at least for the gathering and for the invocation.
Okay, thank you, Doctor.
Dear brothers and sisters in Islam and humanity, do join us tomorrow at the same time when we will be discussing the topic Eid al-Fitr Part 2. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته حافظين ذاكرين قانتين خاشعين مسلمين مؤمنين للإله عابدين شهرنا صوم وعتق وقنوت فيه صدق يومنا صبر ورفق دموع البائسين رمضان قد أهل بالصيام وأطل مسعدا أهلا وخلا لتوفي